The mission of the IAS-9 is to develop machine learning and AI approaches for today's and tomorrow's material science, physical sciences, and engineering disciplines. On the one hand, we bring together experts from the different fields, material science, physics, and AI experts, and start to discuss about the respective problems. The IAS-9 has a number of domain-specific research activities. For example, we are performing simulations ranging from the electronic scale, DFT simulations, through discrete dislocation dynamics simulations, up to the macro scale. In all these cases, so predicting the evolution of microstructure is always of the utmost interest to us.
So the most exciting part in the work I'm doing in IAS-9 is I'm trying to bind two different approaches, which is making sure that we can still keep the physics within the machine learning approaches. So for that, I'm designing new tools based on generative models to be able to help designing new materials and new methods for machine learning for physics.
The idea is that we look at the structural property relations in materials and address some of the current challenges for materials design. If we want to have some data-driven approaches, we need to apply semantic technologies to the data, so we also generate high-quality interoperable data and extract knowledge and structural knowledge out of these for new applications.
We also try to replace conventional or difficult simulations by AI. Deep learning had revolutionized data analysis across multiple domains, because it provides a powerful tool to analyze data automatically.
I am working with simulation data. The application of deep learning is especially beneficial for the analysis of the data because my data is complex and it is also nonlinear. So it can help facilitating a more accurate prediction in the end.
In our institute, we were using a foundation model and multimodal self-supervised learning to learn the richful representation from different properties of the material and use that to guide the design of the materials, especially in the field of solar materials.
We really want to understand all the details that comes out of our AI models when it discovers a relationship or complex patterns in the data and in the simulations. To overcome this challenge, we analyze every single layer of our AI models that we developed. We checked every signal that passes through the layers of our AI models, and this data can be still high dimensional and difficult to interpret, and then we used linear or non-linear or deep learning and statistical based dimension reduction methods so that we can make the data and the signals human readable and we can learn how our AI models learn.
Our world is three-dimensional and so should be the science. And so this is why we are trying to do as many as possible 3D simulations.
So AI and machine learning is used to automate image processing tasks in electron microscopy. These include denoising, segmentation, 3D reconstruction, and analysis of nanoparticles and other structures in electron microscopy data.
IAS-9 has chosen to use a cross-disciplinary approach in our work. This has a range of benefits. One of them are that we have all in one place under one roof domain experts, for example, from material science or physics. We have AI experts who are doing the model development, and at the same time, we also have data stewards and software developers.
You need to work with domain scientists and the computer scientists who bring the AI to the table. In between, you also need people who help to translate between the two groups of scientists, because often enough, we don't speak the same language. One of the largest challenges for material science for probably the next decades is sustainability. That concerns the reuse and recycling of materials, but also securing supply chains and limiting the computational effort, meaning the energetic and carbon footprint of our simulations.
To achieve our ultimate vision, we are always looking for interested and interesting enthusiastic people who would like to, for example, work as a PhD student or as a postdoc for the IAS-9.
The most exciting part of my work is that we are at the forefront of materials informatics and change the way that we do science. Here, IAS-9 offers me the opportunity to learn and further develop new research interests. And it is also really fun to work in an interdisciplinary team.
Taking a look at the future of material science and engineering in conjunction with machine learning and AI, I see a number of significant changes. For example, machine learning and AI will be able to, let's say, closely connect with experiments and thereby also to bring theory and modeling and experiment much closer together.